Hi everyone, I just got my Haygain hay steamer and I wanted to do a little video because I had trouble finding one online of how you go ahead and assemble the Haygain when you get it. So I have here the Haygain HG One system. There's a few different systems available obviously, and so I'm going to walk you through putting this one together. So the things you should have received in the box are the manual, which you see here, some cleaner, your gloves, which are going to be important when you're getting hot hay out, this hose right here, your system's going to come with a top, and then you're also going to have receive this pitcher, as well as a funnel and your steaming portion. So those are the items you should have in the box. Take a look when you get it to make sure they're all there. And then once you have them all, what you're going to do is you're going to go ahead and get out your steamer, and then you're going to plug that into an outlet. It's really important that you plug it straight into the outlet and that you have your system on a hard floor that has a good ability to be able to drain. So you can see I have it here. And the first thing you're going to do is take this hose right here and you want to plug that into your system. So if you turn it around, you're going to plug it into this green hose here by pulling back on the tab and inserting it, and there it's connected. And then you want to hook that up here to your steamer. So same way, you just pull back on the nozzle and then insert it. Then I've gone ahead already and filled this up with some good distilled water, and you want to unscrew the cap right here. And then you'll take your funnel, put it in, and then you'll fill it up, and it can take up to a gallon of water. It's also really important that periodically you're checking your water levels, and in a second I'll show you how to do that, because if the steamer doesn't have water, it can actually ruin your machine. And then additionally, as far as placement of your machine goes, you want to make sure that it's not near dry hay, in addition to the things I mentioned before about where to put it. So there, all the water went in like you saw. And you can use this stick that comes attached to see how much water is in there and measure it. So you can see how much water I have by how wet it got there. Then you're gonna put your cap back on. And that's it, it's pretty simple. All of your assembly is now done and you can get ready to steam some hay.